Good evening, students. Today I will continue with the next part of your current electricity chapter, that is with the cell. Okay. So what do you mean by cell basically? Cell is basically a device which generates electricity by using chemical energy. All of you know this. Okay. A cell consists of two things, that is electrodes and electrolysis. What is electrodes? Electrodes are basically the cathode and anode basically. And cathode is being connected with the negative terminal and anode is being connected with the positive terminal. Okay. All of we know this pretty well. Okay. So, if I draw a cell. So, this is positive and this is negative. Okay. So, electrodes are the conductor through which current can pass. They can be in form of wire, rod or plates. So, if I connect these two things, positive and negative. So, here this will, this connecting point will treat as the electrode. Okay. Hopefully, it is clear to all. Now, in case of galvanic cell, if we consider the galvanic cell, there are two electrodes in the form of rod, right? One is zinc and another is copper. So, for the galvanic cell, the electrodes will be zinc and copper, okay? Electrolytes is the substance where free ions are present, because of which it can conduct electricity. Okay, in galvanic cell, what is the electrolytes? Electrolytes are basically zinc sulfate or copper sulfate. These two are used as the electrolytes. Okay, so why? Because zinc has the tendency to become zinc ion. So, in what it will form basically, if I electrolyze this part, so it will produce Zn2+ SO4 2-. So this is positive cation and this is negative anion, right? So cation will goes to cathode and anion will goes to anode, right? All people know that. So zinc has the tendency to release two electrons, to lose two electrons. So basically zinc will comes out as Zn2+ by releasing two electron, or instead of we write like this. Okay, clear? And copper ion has the tendency to gain electron and become, if I consider it is as, instead of zinc I have considered as Cu, so it will become Cu2+, it will become Cu and it is also Cu. Clear? Okay. Now, the thing is that current always flows from cathode to anode through external circuit. So, if a battery is there, a cell is there that is positive and negative, so it always flows from positive to negative in this direction, that is from cathode to anode. Okay. So, this is for the current. Current flows through, if there is an external circuit, then the current flows from cathode to anode, right? And if electrolytes are there present, so for the electrolytes purposes, current always flows from anode to cathode. So, these are the basic difference between the current part as well as the electrolytes part. Okay. Clear? Okay. Next is that EMF, electromotive force. Okay, let's discuss this part. EMF. What is EMF? EMF is defined as the potential difference between electrodes when there is no current in the cell. So, suppose if this is the circuit, plus minus. Okay. So this is not being connected. This plus is not connected with this negative part. Suppose this is not being connected. So this is open circuit, I can say that. Because if current starts to flow from here, it cannot comes to, or it cannot goes to and end at the negative part, right? So that's why it is the EMF. So what is the potential difference between these two electrodes or between this battery? That is defined as basically the EMF. So EMF is defined as the potential difference between the electrodes when there is no current in the cell. Okay. So EMF of the cell initiates the flow of the current in the cell. Clear? Now, how you will mathematically represent this EMF? Mathematical representation of this EMF will be like this. That will be V1 if 1 is V1 minus of minus 2 V2. So, this will be V1 plus V2. Clear? Now, internal resistance. What do you mean by internal resistance? Internal resistance is the resistance offered by the electrolyte and electrodes when the current flows. Okay. The electrolytes and electrodes oppose the flow of current. Right. So internal, suppose if I represent its internal resistance as small r, suppose consider a cell of two electrolytes are connected by the external resistance capital R. Suppose this is one cell and this is another cell. These two are being connected by an external resistance capital R. Clear? And this is suppose copper cathode and this is zinc anode. Zinc anode, copper cathode. Clear? Now from cathode to anode the current will flow like this. Clear? As the current will flow, so as it is anode, so it is negative and this is positive, right? So from the zinc anode, electron will goes here, and as it is positive, electrons come here. Okay, clear? So from here, electrons will flow like this. So therefore the current will flow like this, always opposite to each other. Clear? So some currents will initially starts from flowing from cathode to anode. If it is a closed circuit, then we can say it like this. Capital V equal to V1 plus V2 minus IR. What is V plus V, V1 plus V2? It is the basically EMF part. Clear? Potential difference. And IR, what is this IR? IR is basically the potential drop across the internal resistance. So this term, I can replace it as capital E. So the my expression will become V equals to E minus IR. Okay? Clear? So, what is the role of this IR or this internal resistance? Basically, internal resistance plays the role only when the circuit is closed. Okay? And it varies from cell to cell and it is very, very much negligible where E greater than equal to IR. Much, much greater than equal to IR. In this condition, it is very much negligible. Okay? So now coming to the cells in combinations of the cells. Okay. First, I will discuss cells in parallel. Combination. Okay. When cells are connected in parallel combinations, all the positive terminals of the cells are connected together and all the negative terminals are connected together. So, the potential difference across the cells is same. Clear? So, like this. Suppose this is E1, this is E2, and this is E3. Clear? So E1 is the potential difference between the first cell, E2 is the potential difference between the second cell, and for this E3 is the for the third cell. Okay? Now I consider for the internal resistance for this is R1, this is R2, and this is R3. This is the internal resistance. So if it is A and B, so both these cases, for each cases, it is suppose E. The potential difference between A and B considered as E, and it is being bred by this one and this one, right? Okay. Now, the condition is that, so potential difference for this part, for this, in general, if I make it considered as B. Okay. So in general it will be basically V equal to E1 minus I1 R1. If current is passing through this, so it will be I1, I2 and I3. Like this. So for this, I1 will be E1 minus B by R1. Clear? So in a similar way, I2 will be E2 minus B by R2. So we know that I equal to I1 plus I2. Just putting the values. Clear? So for this putting the value, what we will get? We will get E1 by V by R1 plus E2 by V by R2. Clear? It will be I. So from here, by the calculations or derivations, what we are getting? We will get, basically V equal to I of R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 plus E1 R1 plus E2 R2 by R1 plus R2. So by simplifying this equation, from here I am getting this. Okay? Clear? So what will be that? Instead of these two cells, here I have considered two cells. Instead of these two cells, I can consider only one cell, right? So instead of that, if I consider only one cell, then what will be the value of that V? V will be basically E equivalent minus IR equivalent. Right? So, and from the previous equation, what I am getting? I will get 1 by I into R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 plus E1 R1 plus E2 R2 by R1 plus R2. By comparing these two equations, what we are getting? We are getting basically equivalent, just comparing the E part, okay? Equivalent equal to E1 R1 plus E2 R2 by R1 plus R2. And R equivalent, as the equations is basically in the parallel, sorry, resistance in the parallel part. So R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So this is the equivalence of the cells. Clear? Okay. So when we are connecting these cells in the series combinations, these basically increase the voltages, and when the cells are connected in parallel, it increases the current basically. Okay. Now I think this part already done. Okay. Next, in the next part, I will continue with the Kirchhoff's law. That is the Kirchhoff's KCL and KVL part. Okay. And from there, I will continue with some numericals. So today, I am completing this video. Thank you.